Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Foothill High School's production of Henrietta VIII, a 50s-style comedy by Kurtz Gordon. I'm Violet, and I'd like to take this time to ask you to please silence all cell phones or chatty friends during the show. Let's face it, folks. Talking and texting during the production is not only distracting to other audience members, but to the actors as well. Oh, no flash photography or video. And remember, this is a comedy, so if something's funny, feel free to laugh. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Extinct all right, nothing like it used to be.
Of course not, dear. We're going through a bloodless revolution, and the juvenile delinquency in our fair city is frightening. Oh, I do hope I get that appointment on the parole board. Judge Crandall thinks I'm just the woman for the job. Being a mother, you know.
What's so miraculous about being a mother? It can happen to anybody.
Not to boys.
They're lucky.
Carol, dear, you're not to talk like that. After all, decency has its limitations.
It can keep them too. Nobody wants them.
Why, Wilma, what's come over you?
A corn crib by the name of Dizzy Lucas.
He's not some double-jointed public menace like your Baggy Pants Baldwin.
Who is Baggy Pants Baldwin?
I've never met him.
Don't worry, Mother. You will.
You can't be that fortunate forever.
Listen to her ooze feminine jealousy. She's positively sticky.
I do wish you girls would be more particular with your language. It's most important at your ages.
Don't let it throw you, Mother. It's all as adolescent as the measles.
They'll outgrow it.
Listen to the old hag howl.
They tell me she doesn't dare go down any theater alley where they're playing Macbeth. She's afraid they'll haul her in for the witch scene.
No, that's not very nice, Carol. You should respect your sister. She's older than you.
Oh, let them have their little fun, Mother.
After all, they're still children.
Carol, dear, turn on the kettle and add a pinch of arsenic. Old lace is in our hair again.
They can't get over the fact that I'm 20 years old and still unmarried.
Oh, I think 20 is a lovely age.
All antiques are lovely.
When I'm 20, I'll be married and have a family. I certainly won't be molding in the matrimonial market.
Getting married isn't everything, Carol. The world offers other opportunities.
Adele is going to be a career girl.
If there's anything worse than being a career girl, it's being a school teacher.
But don't let them upset you, Adele. They're only trying to irritate you.
Oh, they mean all right, Mother. I'm used to them. Well, I guess I'll have to wash these out myself.
I'll be so glad when my new secretary arrives. Then she can look after you girls well enough.
When do you expect her, Mother?
The agency said she'd be here sometime this week. You girls had better pick up your things. The table's no place for them, you know. I'll answer it. Hello? Yes, this is Mrs. Sutton speaking. Who? Oh, yes, the agency. What did you say her name was? Henrietta Carver. Oh, fine. Thank you very much. That was the agency. They said our new secretary would be here this afternoon.
Her name is Henrietta Carver.
I want you both to be especially nice to her.
Of course we will, Mother.
Aren't we always?
You could be a little bit more considerate. After all, you are getting old enough to do for yourself. Oh dear, it's 2:30 already. I've got some shopping to do, and I must be at the Ladies 3:30 Club ahead of Annabelle Mason, or she'll get to speak first. When Henrietta arrives, make sure to show her straight to her room and make her feel right at home.
One of these days, circumstances are going to force me into a very chummy relationship with an electric iron.
It can't be so hard to use. All you do is plug it in, wait a few minutes, spit on it, and if it sizzles, push it back and forth.
Much too laborious for my tender years.
How far do you think we can go with the new secretary?
Can't tell until we size her up.
What's her name again?
Henrietta. No one but a goon would have a name like that.
She'll make the eighth secretary Mother's had so far.
She does not have much luck with them.
What's so hilarious about that?
Do you know what that makes her?
No, so give it the giggle.
That makes her Henrietta the Eighth.
Well, what do you know? So it does. We'll have to christen her when she arrives.
Will a bottle of Coke do the trick?
Oh, nothing so common as Coke. Champagne.
She'll probably be more the beer type.
Okay, we'll launch her with a bottle of stale beer.
Look, snazzy.
What?
Green?
How come?
It's quite a fad with Cokes at this ball.
I think it's super.
Looks clashy to me, but if it's the rage, so be it.
I wonder how blue and gold would look.
Simply terrific.
I'll get it.
Bird brain Dizzy. Take him away.
I'm here.
So I see.
Ain't she glad?
I don't know yet, Dizzy. I've got to look you over.
Oh, Dizzy, that shirt and that tie? No!
No, no, no. Wilma, not again.
Oh, yes, again. Until you learn what shirts to combine with ties, you can't stay in this house with anything so atrocious as that.
Oh, come on. Have a heart. Can't a guy dress when he wants to?
Not in the sanctuary of color and taste.
Oh, come on, that's the eighth tie this month.
Make it even by the dozen. Maybe that time he'll learn not to wear a striped shirt with a striped tie.
more than it does you.
But it costs me more. You're going to be expensive.
What will I do with this one?
Throw it away. It nauseates me.
Odious is the word for this corny rabbit.
Not never ruin it.
Nothing could ruin a thing like this.
Aw. A dollar and a half. Down the drain.
No. Up the flue. It'll help build a nice fire.
How am I supposed to take you to the movies now? I don't got a tie.
It'll be worth it if you buy the right one.
Come with me and I'll give you your first academic lesson in primary colors and how to blend them.
Now look at that. What do you see?
Well, what's it supposed to be?
Don't be a bunion brain dizzy. That's an abstract painting.
Yeah, but a painting of what?
I don't know yet. I haven't made up my mind. I'll get it.
If you don't know what you're painting, why paint it?
It's kind of complicated, Dizzy. I don't know what it is yet, but my subconscious mind does.
And when that door opens,
What door?
The door to my subconscious, you dope!
What brings you here so early, Baldy?
Don't you know? The Blitz Brothers will be here any second.
Did you hear that, Wilma? The Blitz Brothers are going to be here.
Oh, right. I ran into Dom last night at the corner drug gurgling a soda.
He said they'd be over this afternoon around 3.
Why don't you tell me these things?
We gotta be prepared. The Blitz Brothers will only give us playing time for one platter. You guys move the end table. Wilma, help me move this couch.
They're bringing a new platter with them, and baby, it's so hot, it melts off just like butter.
I don't know why you girls like those rat racers. They're not even acrobats. They're not even dancers. They're just acrobats.
They're setting the pace for the Coke set individually this year. If they don't patronize you, you're practically ignored.
Practically ostracized. If you're renting on their wing list, she ain't on anything.
Boy, babe.
Let's get set. They'll be here in a few seconds.
Boy, do they love their name, Blitz. They go in and out of the house like a hurricane.
Here they come, and half the Coke set with them.
No!
No wonder with the hot platter they're carrying with them.
Come on, get ready.
I'm right with you.
Who lets them in?
No one. They invade.
Yeah. Wow! Yeah!
Right, that's the way we like to find you girls, right on the starting line, don't we, Don?
You bet. You got some poems left. Let's get going.
Spin the platter, Baldy.
It's all set.
And what a platter. They cooked that one on the front burner.
Impacted it thirst to keep it hot.
And
hot. Hey,
get ready.
Get set.
Go.
Besides, I don't even know the girl anyway, so why should I care?
Now you're talking sense, Jimmy. It'll only be 2 or 3 weeks that you put on the charm. After the rape, that's all there is to it.
Sounds swell the way you put it.
When the papers put the story that Claire Sutton's daughter was arrested in the raid of a notorious roadhouse with photos on the front page, Claire's expected appointment may take quite a different turn.
Turns my stomach every time I think of it.
I'll tell you what, Jimmy. I'll make you an attractive offer.
No thanks. I'll sit the next one out.
If I get the appointment on the parole board, I'll give you a new car as a bonus. How's that?
Okay. Might as well get as much out of this as I can. So when do I meet the girl and start putting on the charm?
I'll see if she's in.
Adele, yoo-hoo, you home?
Who is it?
Annabelle Mason.
I'm upstairs, Mrs. Mason. Come on up.
Light the fuse on that charm, Jimmy. It's where you start to earn the new car.
Nuts.
He's been dying to meet some nice young girl since he came to live in our city, and I want you to see that he isn't lonely, for my sake.
I'll do my best, Mrs. Mason.
I knew you wouldn't let me down. There he is now. Jimmy, why don't you come on over here and meet the nicest girl in our beautiful city? Jimmy, this is Adele Sutton, the girl I've been raving about. Adele, Jimmy Howard.
Hello.
Hello.
I didn't expect to meet anyone as nice as you.
Does that mean I rave?
And how? Oh, sorry.
Don't be. I rather liked it.
I did too.
Sorry to interrupt, but I must be on my way. I have an important speech to make tonight. I think I'll take a taxi and leave the car. That way I avoid a parking problem downtown. Why don't you take Adele and spin around the country? It's a rather nice day for it.
Maybe I will.
Well, gotta go. Can't keep the dear ladies waiting. I have an important speech to make. Have fun.
It is a nice day.
Perfectly grand. Oh dear, what a mess! Look at this room and those bottles!
Looks like a party.
No, it's that Coke set of my sister's. I heard them down here a while ago. They leave a wake of bottles wherever they go. Excuse me, I'll speak to Maddie, our housekeeper, and have her clean this up.
Let's not, and say we did.
Oh, but I must. It looks like a tornado hit it.
Forget it. Mrs. Mason had the right idea. Let's go for a spin.
Well, I...
Say yes.
Well? All right.
Perfect. Any special place you have in mind?
Do you think we've got time to go up to the lake?
We've got time to go to the moon, if you say. You name the place, and I'll not spare the horses.
The lake will do nicely.
The lake it is. Grab a wing and hold on tight. I'll see to it that you don't fall off.
Can I depend on that?
Like the Lloyd's of London.
Walls completely consumed.
constructed of brick last year. The furniture's modern too.
Ooh, I'm having nightmares again. Yeah, Henny, come over here. This you must see.
What is it?
Your guess is as good as mine. Take a look.
Why, it's a painting.
So that's what it is.
You know what this does to me, Ray? It gives me the feeling of...
Yes, I know. That upstairs, first door to your left sort of feeling.
Nothing of the sort. Take a good look at this painting. Don't you feel the presence of color there?
When it comes to feeling color, I go haywire. When I'm in the blue, I look white. When I'm in the pink, I feel bilious. And when I'm in the purple, I don't feel anything.
I'm really serious about this, Red. Whoever painted this has an excellent color sense.
But no talent.
There are other ways of being an artist, too.
Whoever painted that has spots in front of his eyes.
Well, we might as well get comfortable until someone shows up.
Want me to stay here with you and deliver you into the hands of your new boss?
At least keep me company until somebody puts in an appearance.
How long do you plan to stay on this job?
Not more than 2 weeks.
Maybe more than you bargained for.
I'll take that risk.
Okay, shall we say 2 weeks and then a brief huddle with the Justice of the Peace?
When you say I do, darling, it'll be after a long journey down the church aisle with all the trimmings in my hometown.
Spare me that, please, Henny. Not a church wedding.
It's practically painless, dear.
But do we have to?
Yes, I promised Mother. You see, we've never had a church wedding in our family before.
Why make me the guinea pig? It's just as legal the other way, not a whole lot easier.
No church, no wedding.
It's coercion to force me into a lot of pomp and ceremony. I've half a mind to renege.
You can't. Remember, a promise is a promise, and a ring isn't cabbage.
I'll say not. Send me back a lot of lettuce. But I could deny ever giving it to you.
No, you couldn't. Not with this inscription on it.
Why won't I ever learn to remember my great old pappy's dying words? Never put nothing in writing, son.
So, church wedding still goes?
You're not going to wear that thing on your new job, are you? Mrs. Sutton may not like the idea of you being engaged.
I hadn't thought of that. Perhaps it would be wise not to.
Give it to me. I'll take care of it for you.
All right. Now be careful.
All I'll do is take it to the jewelers and have them remove the inscription.
You fiend! Give it back!
Nothing doing, darling.
Oh, yes, you will.
Keep that up. You only wear yourself out.
We'll see about that.
This isn't fair. You're taking advantage. Get up and fight me like a man.
Do you give up?
Never.
Well, then you asked for it.
Ow! Oh, my God! Oh! Oh!
Hello!
Oh! Hello yourself! Oh, Grandma, what big teeth you have! Oh! 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 Hello?
Nice going. I like the way you handle your man. My name's Wilma. This is my sister, Carol.
I'm Henrietta Carver.
Oh, yes. Mother's new secretary.
Henrietta the eighth.
I'm sorry, eighth what?
Eighth secretary. Well, what's it gonna be? Stale beer, Coke, or champagne?
Dipsomaniacs. Proof.
She's certainly not the beer type, and too old for Coke. Make it champagne.
I wish you would explain this beverage conversation.
Well, since you're Henrietta the Eighth, we thought it called for a bit of launching. It sounds rather regal, like the name of an ocean liner, a cruiser, or
a battle wagon.
Who's the handsome male animal?
Oh, I beg your pardon. This is Mr. Taylor.
It's about time. Hello.
Not
again.
Bad. You sure know how to pick them.
Oh, Mr. Taylor is an old friend. He's kindly consented to drive me over.
He doesn't look so old.
Oh, that the trap door of your memory.
Is Mrs. Sutton here?
Oh, yeah, she's expecting you. In fact, she told us to make you feel immediately at home.
That was very kind of her.
Well, what are we waiting for? Well, all right. Well, all right, let's go. You can press this, trust me. While you're waiting for Mother and these
these two. You'll find the ironing board and the electric iron in the kitchen.
Well, come on, I'll beat you to the shower.
Says you.
If they think I'm going to press their clothes for them, they're crazy.
Well, good hunting, Henrietta the Eighth. You asked for it, sister. Oh, what's going on over here?
Oh, my God!
Where are the empty Coke bottles?
There, on the floor.
Never mind, we changed our mind. We need the 2 cents.
Yeah, it's a jumping little record I want my jockey to play. Over Beethoven, I gotta hear it again today. You know my temperature rising, the jukebox blowing the fuse. My heart beating rhythm and my soul keep a singing the blues.
Or stress more strongly the challenging menace of our several questionable roadhouses that flourish brazenly on the outskirts of our fair city. Their neon lights and glittering entrances lure our young people into dens of dance, drink, and gambling, a veritable incubator for juvenile delinquency. These must go and will go. I pledge my untiring efforts to the accomplishment of this goal. The usual 6 copies, Miss Carter. One for the press, one for myself, and one for the files.
When do you want them by, Mrs. Sutton?
Tomorrow morning will do very nicely. I'm due to deliver a speech tomorrow evening at the Ladies' Board of Trade. Wives of their husbands, you know. Oh dear, it's 2:30 already. I've got to be at the Women Who Think Club ahead of Annabelle Mason.
What do you think of Mrs. Mason?
I do not like her. She's sneaky, just can't trust her.
Really?
But I don't dare let her out of my sight, at least not until Judge Crandall has me appointed for the parole board.
That appointment means a great deal to you, doesn't it, Mrs. Sutton?
It's something I want more than anything else. I don't know what I shall do if I'm not appointed.
There's always your home, Mrs. Sutton.
Home? Home.
Yes, home. Millions of women have made a successful career of it.
Oh, I'm not the home type at all, Miss Carver. Never was. George used to say to me, my husband, you know, before he died, "Doll baby," my pet name, you know, "doll baby," he would say, "you were weaned on a powder puff and not a mixing spoon, and the kitchen will always be as foreign to you as Mars." And my, how right he was. I must go and start dressing, or Annabelle will be here long before I'm ready.
Don't touch me with that filthy brush.
All I want to do is put a red spot on your right cheek
and a green one on your left cheek and a purple one on your nose and a great big black one on your forehead.
Leave me alone. You frighten me.
Boo.
Oh!
Wilma, are you teasing Lizzie again?
Oh, Killjoy is here.
You're a young woman, Wilma. I think it's time you grew up.
You annoy me, Henrietta. You act like a school teacher.
I'm sorry you feel that way. I had great hopes you and I would get along well together.
No one likes to be told what he should and do.
You can't go on playing childish pranks your whole life. It's time you grew up, and I'd like to help you.
Help me, she says. If you wanted to help me, you'd press out my dress or wash my stockings once in a while.
You're physically able to look after your own wardrobe.
Well, there's other secretaries used to do it.
I wasn't aware I was supposed to help you with that.
I don't like to do it when it comes to menial labor. So if you would just shut up and give me a hand.
The unfortunate one is you, measuring your values by that flimsy yardstick. We'll only net you the equivalent in heartache.
Oh, really? Just how long have you been with us, Henrietta?
Nearly 2 weeks.
3 weeks will be quite long enough, don't you think?
Meaning what, Wilma?
I've noticed that you haven't worn your engagement ring since you've arrived. Or did you think I hadn't noticed? Mother doesn't like engaged secretaries, she knows.
This wouldn't, by chance, be your subtle attempt at domestic intimidation, would it?
I'm willing to negotiate if you care to stay on.
On what terms?
I've got a neglected wardrobe, several pairs of stockings that could use a touch of luxology, and I simply adore your technique with the electric iron.
I already told you girls, I'm your mother's secretary and will not be saddled with any such additional duties.
Mother will no doubt be delighted to hear of your engagement.
Wilma, please, I'm trying to meet you halfway, but you're making it most difficult.
Pardon me, I feel a yawn coming on.
Mrs. Sutton's secretary speaking. Oh, hello, Mrs. Mason. No, Jimmy isn't here right now, but I think Adele's expecting him. Can I leave a message? Yes, I'll tell Jimmy to wait here for you. You're welcome.
Henrietta?
Yes, Adele?
May I speak to you just for a minute, please?
Of course, Adele. What is it?
Well, I wanted to say I'm sorry for the way I acted last night. It was beastly of me to say those horrid things to you. After all, you have to earn a living, so why should I be so selfish as to add any more unpleasantness than there is?
Thanks, Adele. I do so want to get along with you girls, but it's been most difficult.
I know. We've been pretty rude, and last night, Jimmy overheard what I said to you, and on our way back from the movies, he made me promise I would apologize to you.
So you're only doing this for Jimmy?
No, not really. Look, I know I was wrong, and it's not easy for me to apologize. I am sorry. Really, I am.
I think you mean that, Adele. Thanks.
Then we're friends?
Friends.
Good, it's been plaguing me all day.
So, how are you and Jimmy getting along?
Oh, he's wonderful. I've never met anyone quite like him.
Are you in love with him, Adele?
Uh-huh. Do you think he's nice?
I think he's a very personable young man.
Oh, he's lots more than that. Does love make everyone feel like this, Henrietta?
Everyone who's vulnerable to it.
Have you ever been vulnerable?
Still am.
Are you going to marry him?
If I can hold on to him long enough.
Well, I'm not going to let anyone take Jimmy away from me. Got to mail this right away, or Jimmy won't get it tomorrow morning.
But aren't you seeing Jimmy this afternoon?
Oh, but this is different.
Oh, so that's why you're always the first one up in the morning. Love letters.
Every morning. See you later.
Wait, what should I tell Jimmy if he arrives before you get back?
He won't. I don't expect him for about half an hour.
Hello, Mrs. Sutton's secretary speaking. Oh, hello, Ray. What's on your mind? Yes, I know the 2 weeks are nearly up. No, I really can't. Well, I thought we'd meet in the usual place outside. Ray, don't come here. No, Ray, I... Darn.
Go play your childish marbles with somebody else, Baldy. I'm a serious woman.
What's he in now?
As if you didn't know.
I only dance with Susie while you finish your drink.
Yes, and on the nickel you borrowed from me, too.
I spent my allowance taking you to the movies. You can't play the jukebox without money.
Oh, I don't mind your using my money to dance with her. But I do mind your playing our number when you dance with her.
I'm so used to playing with you, it's a habit.
Baldy, I think the time has come where you and I should have a serious talk. Sit down.
I don't like that look in your eye, Carol.
What's wrong with it?
It's got that sort of, there comes a time in every woman's life when, and I ain't ready for it.
Really, Baldy? I thought you were growing up.
I am, but not that fast.
Well, I'm a serious woman, and I can't be wasting my time on anyone like you.
Good gosh, I'm serious. Sometimes.
Are you serious about me?
Well, I...
Are your intentions honorable or not?
I'll get off those sandbags, Carol. You sound like a cheap movie.
I suppose. You're going to tell me you're not the marrying kind.
A guy's got more important things to think about besides getting married.
What's more important than marriage?
Gee whiz, Carol, a guy's gotta finish college and start a career before he can think about a wife.
The trouble with you, Baldy, is you having an ounce of romance in your whole body.
You ain't see me when I'm in rare form.
Oh, so there's another woman?
I didn't say that.
We are not amused. Good afternoon, Mr. Baldwin.
Huh?
I said, good afternoon, Mr. Baldwin.
You mean I gotta go?
My heart is heavy, my thoughts are burdened with disappointment.
Maybe you aren't feeling well.
I'm heartsick, if that's what you mean.
Maybe you need an aspirin.
That does it! Now beat it! Scram!
Okay.
And don't come back ever until I send for you!
What about our movie day tonight? It's your treat.
Hi, aren't we violent this afternoon?
Men! I'll make him see the light if I have to build a bonfire on his head.
Are you and Baldy having words?
I'm not supposed to speak to you. Wilma and I are on the verge of giving you the silent treatment.
What provoked that?
The way you treat us, as if we were working for you instead of you working for us.
I'm your mother's secretary. I wasn't aware I was supposed to be working for you girls.
You could help us a little if you really wanted to.
I'm only too glad to help you at any time.
Then why don't you keep our clothes pressed?
Because I want you girls to learn to look after yourselves and ask favors of no one.
Sometimes you don't make any sense.
I try to.
And ever since you came here, you've been prying into our little affairs.
That's not true, Carol.
Then why are you always asking us so many questions?
It's the only way I can get you to talk to me.
I know you're the one that's been putting college pamphlets and books in my room, in those interior design magazines in Wilma's.
I thought they would interest you. A college education is important for a girl, don't you think?
You sound like Baldy. All he ever talks about is going to college and having a career, too.
Don't you ever think about that?
Well, I'm going to be a housewife, and a darn good one, too.
That takes schooling, too, Carol.
I'm going to be one in the old-fashioned kind of way.
What way is that?
By doing what comes naturally.
Miss Carter, may I speak with you?
Yes, Lizzie. Why, Lizzie, where are you going?
I can't say. I really can't. I was just waiting so I could see you alone.
You're leaving?
Yes, ma'am.
But why?
I'm frightened.
Who frightens you?
The girls.
Well, why don't you tell Miss Sutton?
Oh, she frightens me, too. Everybody frightens me.
Do I, Lizzie?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I can never stay longer than 2 weeks at any place I work. They sell Mrs. Sutton to send my wages to my daughter's house.
Well, can't you at least stay until I find someone to replace you?
Oh, dear, no. I have heart rumors now.
Well, if you're frightened, I suppose you are. It's a new one on me, though.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I carry your valise to the bus for you?
Oh, dear, no. That would frighten me.
Hello, Marlin Agency? Mrs. Shiloh, please. Hello, Mrs. Shiloh. This is Henrietta Carver. Our cook just quit. Can we get another? She says we all frighten her. Someone a little more modern this time. Oh, fine. Whoever it is, come in, please. Someone's here. I'll have to go. Well, do your best. Thank you.
Nobody home?
Adele went to on an errand. She's expecting you.
Well, she better. This date is extra special. In fact, I never thought I'd do it.
Do what, Jimmy?
Give a girl an engagement ring. I thought I was the bachelor type before I met Adele. Want to see it?
Of course.
There.
Beautiful, may I?
Sure, go ahead.
Why, this is the most beautiful engagement ring I've seen in years. Does Adele know?
Not yet. You don't think she'll say no, do you?
There's only one way to find out. Ask her.
If she says no today, I'll ask her again tomorrow, and the next day, and the next, until she says yes.
No.
There's no harm in trying. How's the new job going, Jimmy?
Great. Got off early today, and I'm expecting a promotion before long.
Mrs. Mason was responsible for your good luck there, wasn't she?
She arranged the interview, but I talked myself into getting the job.
Good for you.
Hello, Jimmy.
Oh, well, look who's here. Nifty number you're wearing. This calls for shoulder rubbing with the elite. We'll dine and dance in the mirror room. Get your wrap and we'll take off.
Be down in a jiffy. Take care of him, Henrietta.
I will. Oh, Mrs. Mason called. She says she wants you to wait here until she arrives.
What does she want?
She didn't say. Sounds like her now. Excuse me.
Hello, Jimmy. I'm glad you waited.
Hello.
I'll tell Mrs. Sutton you're here, Mrs. Mason.
Thank you. Well, Jimmy, it's all settled. The police have agreed to cooperate with me. If a
photographer's been arranged for, and the wait is all set for next Friday night. Now all you have to do is be there with Adele by 10 o'clock.
Suppose she won't go.
It's up to you to see that she does, or else.
What if I refuse?
You won't. I know how much you love your father.
Don't be too sure I won't.
We'll see. Besides, there's the bonus of the new car, you know. It'll be delivered to you next Friday morning.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Annabelle.
Not at all.
Oh, hello, Jimmy.
Hello, Mrs. Sutton.
Shall we go now?
Right away.
Who's that strange woman who's been to all the women's clubs lately?
Mrs. Radcliffe, a social worker. And they say she's a rather close friend of Judge Crandall's.
All righty, Jimmy. Hey there. What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
Jimmy, is something worrying you?
No. What makes you think so?
Intuition, probably?
No such thing. Come on, let's see what our betters do for excitement.
Enjoy yourselves.
We will.
Whoever that is, send it in.
We will.
May I come in?
No.
Thanks.
Ray, you're being difficult.
Didn't you promise to marry me in 2 weeks?
I'm not referring to that. It's your coming here. We definitely decided to meet outdoors so we could talk freely. I don't let anyone in this house know why I'm really here.
Well, your 2 weeks are up, and you have what you came for, so what do you care?
I do care. A lot.
What's going on here that I don't know?
Oh, Ray, they're a really nice family when you get to know them. They have their faults, but haven't we all?
Oh, so we're going to praise Caesar rather than bury him.
Oh, Ray, be patient, please. It's going to take longer than I planned.
How patient do you expect a man to be who's counting down the days to marry the woman he loves?
I'm so glad to hear you say that, Ray. Oh, Ray, don't look like that. One would think I was breaking our engagement.
This could be the overture to it, you know?
You know perfectly well that it isn't.
Then, let's set a date. Now.
Ray, I'll marry you the day my work here is finished. You choose the place.
You mean, no church wedding?
Whatever you say.
It's a bargain. See you tomorrow then. Same place?
Same place. Did you bring your car?
Yes. Why?
I have an errand to do. Will you drop me off in town?
Delighted. Anything to get you in that car again.
No tricks now.
Nothing I couldn't do with my hands tied behind me.
Knowing you, that's plenty.
She's not here.
What?
She's not here.
Louder, please.
Henrietta isn't here. We only wear the earmuffs when she's in the room with us. It's part of the silent treatment. And don't forget how we operate when she does show up. Maybe she's in there. I'll take a look. Nope, not in there.
What do we do now?
Hold on to the earmuffs. And whenever Henrietta does show up, we put them on and go into our act.
Then Mother can get a new secretary.
And this time we'll break the new one in right.
I'll give that.
If it's Henrietta, put on the earmuffs.
It's Dizzy.
Hello.
Hello. Dizzy, dear, come to Mama.
Do you mean I look all right?
Oh, fine. Just standing. All but that time!
Well, I'm gonna write a little letter. I'm gonna mail it to my local DJ. Yeah, it's a jumping little record. I want my jockey to play. Beethoven, I gotta hear it again today. You know my temperature rising, the jukebox blowing the fuse. My heart beating rhythm and my soul keep a singing the blues. I roll over Beethoven, tell Tchaikovsky the news. I got the rocking pneumonia, I need a shot of rhythm and blues. I caught the rolling off the writer sitting down at a rhythm review.
Getting better with every session.
You're not so bad yourself.
Our batteries are fully charged.
So soon, see you subsequently.
They certainly give us a workout. Human dynamos. One day, they'll blow a fuse.
Have you seen Baldy anywhere today?
No.
Why should I be looking for that squirt?
He's not a squirt.
Okay, I thought he was on your blacklist.
That was last week.
But if he doesn't show up soon, I'll put him back there.
Tekka is getting to be an issue.
Don't tell me you're not capable of handling Baldy.
I've been getting some good ideas from our new cook, Martha.
What does Martha know about handling men?
She didn't have to take up geometry to know that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. And if that's the starting point to any man's love, I'm either going to use a stomach pump on Baldy or learn how to cook.
You're just the two I wanted to talk to. I suppose you think it's cute and smart to send me on fool's errands all over the city while you have your outside stooges call me on the phone. Very pretty. Now can we get down to business? Take those things off of your ears and listen to me. Fine, your allowance will be withheld for the next week.
What?
Your allowance will be withheld until your behavior is more becoming of ladies your age.
What has that got to do with our allowance?
Your mother has made me the keeper of the dole as of this morning. You now get your allowance from me.
She can't mean that. She wouldn't do a thing like that.
Ask her when she gets home. And with that, I leave you two little chairs off into your dance again.
Sabotage, that's what it is.
We're getting under her skin. She's only trying to irritate us.
Sure, that's it. Those phone calls did the trick, all right.
You don't think we overdid it, do you?
Not a chance. She's a diehard, but one more week of our silent treatment and we'll have her on the run.
Now that your super boyfriends have left, how about you girls putting this room in order?
We're taking a 10-minute break, Martha, discussing high finance.
I spent over an hour and a half putting this room to rights this afternoon. So, on your feet, the both of you, and we'll have this room back to shape in a jiffy.
When are you going to make some more of those full cream puffs?
Maybe tomorrow, if you girls are nice and cooperate.
Hear that, Carol? On your feet and give us a hand.
And we won't use my own noses.
Just hitch them to this lounge for the present.
Martha, how did you ever learn to influence people and win friends?
I wanted to marry the man I loved, and I adopted the quickest way of doing it.
And how's that?
I cooked my own right into the cockles of his heart.
Where is he now?
In the hospital, of course. He just couldn't leave my eight Birmingham and Love, Carol and Edward alone.
You don't have a secret cook you can lend me, do you?
There's a dandy one right out in the kitchen you can have. Every recipe is foolproof.
And she knows just the food to try him on, too.
Then lead me to the magic of this open sesame.
Is there any special dish you'd like to try?
I want to make a pie. An apple pie. I bet I can make as good of a pie as you ever did.
Have you seen Henrietta?
Seen and heard.
Where is she?
In her room, probably. Well, aren't we snazzy? Where'd you find that nifty number?
At Ruddles.
We shop at the best places, don't we?
This is a special occasion.
Well, royalty has no less on the knee tonight.
Where are you and Jimmy headed for? The Ritz?
No, nothing so tame as that. We're hitting one of the hotspots.
Where?
Jimmy's taking me to the Rodeo Roadhouse.
Hotspot is right, that's a gambling joint.
I've always had a yen to see what it's like inside.
I don't think Mother would approve. She's dead set against roadhouses.
I'll be perfectly safe with Jimmy.
Well, watch your step just the same.
I'm surprised Jimmy's taking me there.
We're only going to dance and watch what goes on.
That's what they all say. That first. Oh, here's where I came in.
What brought that on?
Oh, well, like Carol giving me the silent treatment.
What are they up to?
They're campaigning to undermine my morale, so I'll resign.
Well, don't you let them do it.
I won't. Your mother unwittingly gave me a good counterattack. She's putting me in charge of their lives. She doesn't want them to have too much money at one time.
Good for Mother. Well, how do I look?
Magnificent! Jimmy's going to get an eyeful of beauty tonight.
Oh, Henrietta, you're a dear. I don't know what I would have done if it weren't for someone like you around to talk to these past few weeks. I would have burst. I'm that happy.
You're not secretly engaged to Jimmy, are you?
No, not yet. But I think he may ask me. Maybe tonight. I have a feeling something big and surprising is going to happen.
Sounds like your opportunity ringing now. Keep your fingers crossed.
Hello, Adele.
Hello, Jimmy.
For you.
Oh, thank you, Jimmy. It's beautiful.
Well, how does that look?
All right, I guess.
Oh, Jimmy, you don't act the least bit interested, and you haven't even noticed my new gown.
It's all right.
Don't you think it's becoming?
It'll do.
Jimmy, what's the matter with you? You don't act like yourself at all.
I'm all right.
Jimmy Howland, do you know what I think?
Must you?
I don't think you give two boots whether you take me out tonight or ever.
Don't say that, please. You know it isn't so. Just get your wrap and we'll be on our way.
All right. I'll put on the corsage too. It won't take long.
Well, you're in a fine, lovable mood, aren't you, Jimmy? What did you do? Sit on the wrong side of the bed when you put your socks on this morning? Or was it something you ate?
You needn't rub it in.
You don't look too happy for a fellow who's supposed to be engaged.
I'm not engaged.
I could tell by Adele's finger. What did you do? Get cold feet or have a relapse in bacheloritis?
I'd rather not talk about it, if you don't mind.
Sorry, I didn't mean to intrude.
Please forgive me. I have something on my mind.
Jimmy, something's really bothering you, isn't it?
More than you'll ever know.
Well, confession's good for the soul, and I'm an awfully good listener.
It's too late. They paid you to saw with a new car. It's a swell piece of junk.
All ready, Jimmy.
Coming.
Do you know what I'm thinking, Jimmy?
What?
That this may be a very exciting night for the both of us.
You may get your wish, too. Let's go.
Don't wait up for me tonight. I may be very late.
Enjoy yourselves.
She's not here.
Good.
Carol, how's your homework coming along?
Great. There's a recipe in here that looks irresistible.
Well, Carol, you get your man.
I will. In fact, there's no time like the present to start groundwork. So, Baldy, I toast you a hank of dough, some apples, and thou. I'll get it. Somebody forgot to turn off the faucet. Pat drips back again.
Hi, Dizzy. What's doing?
I'm here to invite you to my going away party.
Going away? Where to?
College. Pop says I gotta be a dentist.
But why?
Because he's one, I guess.
I thought you were gonna be a lawyer.
So did I, but Pop said I'm not a good enough liar.
Oh gosh, a guy can't become an expert liar overnight. He's got to practice.
I tried, but Pop caught me at every one.
Dizzy, you forgot your tie.
No, I didn't. I just didn't think there was much use in putting it on. Do you like it?
Not with what you're wearing.
That's what I thought. That makes 12 ties. There ought to be a lot of averages, it seems to me.
Keep trying, Dizzy. One of these days, who knows?
What are you doing with all my ties, anyway?
Saving them for Christmas presents. My mother, you're really...
Yes, dear, it wasn't very successful.
Hello, Miss Sutton.
Oh, hello, Dizzy. I mean, Harold. I'm so upset, I don't know what I'm saying. Would you hang this up for me like a good boy?
Yes, Miss Sutton.
Mother, is it true that Henrietta is to have complete charge of our allowance?
Yes, dear. I'm so occupied with other more important matters, I thought it would be better this way.
But Mother, she threatens not to give us our allowance unless...
Unless what, dear? Oh, skip it.
I hung it up in the closet in the hallway for you, Miss Sutton.
Thanks, dear. Got to do something, but I don't know what. Where is Miss Corber?
In here, working on your speech for tomorrow night.
And spying on us, no doubt. Mother, do we have to put up
with
this?
That will do, Wilma.
Gosh, Mother, you are mad about something.
And I have a good reason to be. Do you remember that very excellent speech against the roadhouses that I made the other day?
Of course.
Annabelle is trying to capitalize on it. At our dinner party this evening, she made a speech and actually solicited the support of Judge Crandall to start a drive against the roadhouses. And do you know what happened?
Judge Crandall agreed with her.
No! That's not very sporting of her.
All's fair in love and war. And politics, Mother.
I always knew Annabelle was a female cobra, but to deliberately use my platform to spring herself into the limelight is nothing short of treachery.
You should beat her in her own game, Miss Sutton.
Beat her?
Yeah. Have all the joints ready before she does. You'll get all the publicity.
Well, that's a brilliant idea, Harold.
If I was you, I'd call up the police chief tonight and have him raid the worst of the worst, the rodeo roadhouse.
Tizzy, you stay out of this. An excellent suggestion, Harold. I'll have him raid the rodeo roadhouse this very night.
To help see what you've done?
What did I do?
Calm down, Mother. Wait until tomorrow.
I always believed in striking while the iron was hot.
It's hot, all right, but a thing like this takes planning.
I agree with Wilma. One can gain many points by upholding the view of his opponent. I think we'll have that gracious touch Judge Crandall will appreciate.
I suppose you're right, Miss Carver. Judge Crandall is a man to value cooperation, and it may help towards my appointment. I'll get it. Who knows, Miss Carver? Perhaps Annabelle and her treacherous ways may help further my interests more than her own.
Hello, everybody. Where's Carol?
Oh, hello, Baldy. I saw you coming up the street.
Look at your hands. Where have you been?
Oh, that's just flour. I'm making you a nice, big pie.
Pie. What kind?
Apple.
Do I love apple pie?
Any man who doesn't ain't a man.
Carol, dear, aren't you afraid you'll burn yourself?
Martha's helping me. She's swell.
There's going to be a big braid pull tonight.
A braid? Where?
The Rodeo Roadhouse.
How do you know?
Gosh, Otto, my uncle living with us in the police force, he said they're going to raid the place at like 10 tonight.
We gotta stop them.
Stop whom?
I'm telling Jimmy.
Where are they going?
The Rodeo Roadhouse.
How do you know?
Adele told me. I'll stop them. She shan't leave this house.
You're too late, Mother. She's gone.
Come on, Baldy. We can't have them caught in that raid.
Take it easy. Look what you did.
She won't. I'm sorry. Oh, this is terrible. Something must be done.
I know what I'm going to do. I'm going out there and I'm going to get them before the raid.
No one's going anywhere.
Miss Carver, do you realize what you're saying? If my daughter is in that raid, it will mean the end of everything for me. Judge Crandall will never appoint me to the parole board. You, go after her, and you go with her. Make sure you bring Adele back. Spare no expense. Take a taxi. This disgrace would ruin me politically.
Right now, I am not concerned with you, Mrs. Sutton, or the parole board. My immediate interest is in the future happiness of two people.
Miss Carver, that hardly makes any sense. My prominence as a public figure in this city is in jeopardy. My reputation as a leader is at stake.
This is more important than that. It concerns the love of two people.
What does love have to do with it?
I'd hardly expect you to know that, Mrs. Sutton.
Mother, I wouldn't be at all surprised if Henrietta knew more about this raid than we think. I wouldn't put it past her to be in the league of Mrs. Mason and working against us. Looks like a political double-cross to me.
Wilma, how could you?
Oh, I'm not so dumb. I've watched as you make little notes and lock them in the top drawer of your dresser. I've felt all along as if there was something mighty suspicious about you. And now I'm sure of it. And I'm going out there and I'm going to get them before the raid.
Wilma, I won't stop you. But if you go out there tonight, you are going to hurt their relationship. And you could ruin the future happiness of two people.
You talk like a comic book. Come on, Dizzy, let's go.
Let's go.
What's the matter, Jimmy? Is it something I've done or said?
Well, thank heavens they're back.
Don't stand there looking at me like that. What's wrong?
I am. Don't ever see me again. I'm not fit to look at you. I'm no good and never will be, so forgive me.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Don't forget to use the restrooms at your leisure. So come on, folks, follow me.
I hoped everybody enjoyed intermission, and now it's time for the third and final act of Henrietta VIII.
Not the type. Henrietta, why do all girls fall in love with Dotis?
maybe it's because all men are dopes and we haven't a choice.
Look! I did it with my little oven.
That looks delicious.
If it tastes as good as it smells, I'll have a piece that big.
Oh, no you won't. I didn't shake that apple tree for your benefit. This pie was made for the exclusive indulgence of one Baggy Pants Baldwin. If this doesn't get him, he ain't human.
Looks like we're not invited.
Poor Baldy won't stand a chance when confronted with that appetizing masterpiece.
He better not. I put all my love under that top crust.
You better let me carry your dress. You don't want to wrinkle it before the party.
Thanks. Begin. It's your nickel. Jimmy Howard, you've got quite a nerve calling this place after the way you treated Adele. No, Henrietta isn't here, and I wouldn't let you speak to her if she was. Why, you stinker, you! If you want to come talk to Adele, you come face her like a man. I've seen quite some heels in my time, but you certainly are the all-American, all-lowdown. Wrong number!
Do you know who that was on the phone?
It was Jimmy Howard.
Jimmy? What did he want?
He wanted to speak to you. I told him he couldn't.
Carol, you had no right to.
Well, what are you going to do now?
Phone him. He wants to talk to me.
Oh, no, you won't. Where's your pride? If he wants to talk to you, he'll come talk to you in person.
Well, I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Don't let him back on all terms. He hasn't tried to speak to you since last Friday. Now you're just going to let him back? Fine thing.
If I only knew why he did it. It's not like Jimmy to do a thing like that.
Well, he did it, didn't he?
Yes, he did. But he must have had a reason.
If he's so lily-white about all this, why doesn't he come talk to you? Personally, I don't get it.
I've never been in love. You're too young. You don't understand.
The heck I don't? Why do you think I've been slaving away at the red-hot oven? I don't even like apples that much. I'll get it.
Is your mother home, Carol?
Yes, Mrs. Mason. I'll let her know you're here.
Hello, Adele.
Hello, Mrs. Mason.
Have you seen Jimmy lately?
No.
Neither have I. But I'd like to. I have a few things I'd like to say to that young man. He's no good. You are well rid of him.
Don't say things like that. Please.
Why, Adele, dear, you ought to know by now that Jimmy comes from a family that isn't all it should be.
Then why did you bring him here? Why did you introduce me to him?
I didn't know about him then. You see, his father works for our company, and it was only last week we learned that he was being...
Hello, Annabelle. It must be something terribly important to bring you here so late in the afternoon.
It is important, Claire. You see, Judge Crandall has announced his appointee for the vacancy. Who do you think it was?
Well, don't keep me in suspense, Annabelle. The judge appointed me, didn't he?
No, Claire, not you. And not me. He appointed Miss Radcliffe.
Yeah. What? Are you sure?
It'll be announced in the evening paper.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Mason.
Hello, Miss Carver.
Has the evening paper come yet?
Why, no, Mrs. Sutton. It's never delivered here this early.
Annabelle informs me that the judge appointed Mrs. Radcliffe for the vacancy on the parole board.
Is this true, Mrs. Mason?
Why, you see, I'm rather close with the editor, and he called me as soon as the copy reached the press.
I can't believe it. How could Judge Crandall appoint so common a person? I'll protest. I'll write to the mayor. I'll veto!
I think you'll do nothing of the kind, Claire, dear. At this particular moment, it would be more apropos of you to focus your attention to the future of your daughters. Delinquency, you know, begins at home.
And what do you mean by that remark?
That your duty is here, in your own home, with your own children, not trying to run other people's. Adele just missed being engaged to Jimmy, and his father is a thief.
Don't let her say things like that, Henrietta. Make her stop!
Mrs. Mason, you seem to be quite certain of a lot of things.
I know whereof I speak. And if Jimmy does have the audacity to come back, remember I warned you. I have a few things I'd like to say to that young man myself.
Sounds like him now. I talked to him this morning, and he said he was coming to see Adele this afternoon.
Oh, Henrietta, what shall I do?
Don't do anything. Let Jimmy do it. And I'm sure he'll be delighted to see you too, Mrs. Mason. Excuse me.
I never liked you, Annabelle, because I knew I couldn't trust you. I always felt you were trying to undermine me.
Oh, you flatter yourself, Claire. You've never had anything to undermine. You've been the laughingstock of every women's club in the city.
How dare you!
I'm glad you're here, Mrs. Mason. There's a few things I want to clear up.
Where's the car you stole from me?
I never stole anything, and neither did my father. That pawn ticket you found in his vest pocket was planted there by your very own son. He owed a gambling debt at the Rodeo Roadhouse.
A lovely story. Your father was a frequent visitor at the pawn shop. He was well known there.
He only pawned things that belonged to him. He had debts to pay. Your son knew that, and that's why he made my father the scapegoat.
You'll have to prove that.
I can. I have an affidavit from the Rodeo Roadhouse stating that your son owed a gambling debt that was paid off just 2 hours after your jewelry was pawned.
Lies. A network of lies. I'll have you in court for this and your father put in jail.
He's telling the truth, Mrs. Mason. I've been working with Jimmy on this case since the night the Roadhouse was raided.
Why didn't you tell me, Henrietta?
I asked her not to, Adele. I wanted to clear my father's name first before I came to you. You see, that's actually how all this started. Mrs. Mason threatened to put my father in jail if I didn't go along with this little plan of hers. I was to meet Adele, seem interested, and invite her to the Roadhouse where Mrs. Mason had the raid all set to go. She knew publicity like this would end your appointment on the parole board. I agreed because I happened to love my father and my hands were tied.
Then you never meant a single thing you said to me, did you, Jimmy?
I meant every word I said to you, Adele. It wasn't planned by Mrs. Mason for me to actually fall in love. That happened. How do you think I felt after that? Feeling the way I did about you with all this over my head? I couldn't stop seeing you. I spent every day hoping that maybe I wouldn't have to go through with it. But when the time came, I just couldn't do it. I guess I'm weak, Adele. I didn't have the courage to refuse the car because I was afraid of what happened to my father if I did refuse. The car's outside, Mrs. Mason. You can take it with you on your way out. Sorry I've been such a heel. I don't expect you to forgive me. That's asking too much. But I would like a word with Adele. Alone? May I, Adele?
Let's go in here. I knew it. I knew you were trying to undermine me. And you plan to use my daughter as a ruse? Get out. And don't think you've heard the last of this either.
That silk purse manner of yours.
Show her out.
Did you say show or throw?
I like your interpretation better.
So do I.
I know that I'm not wanted. No need to resort to violence.
I've never been so humiliated in my life. To think that all along she was... It's unthinkable.
I'm so sorry all of this happened, Mrs. Sutton.
I don't know what to do now. I lost the appointment.
You still have your home and three beautiful daughters who need your love and guidance.
Yes. My daughters, they do need me, but what do I do first?
Get to know them.
I do know them. I see them every day.
But do you really know them? What they think, what they feel, and what they want to be.
Well, I guess not. They never told me.
Then you've missed something big. After all, you are a mother, Mrs. Sutton.
Well, here I am at my best. Do you think I'll pass inspection?
Wilma, do you know this is the first time I've ever seen you dressed up?
I'm pleased with me, too.
Wilma, dear. Don't you think it's time we get to know each other a little better?
Mother, you haven't taken to drink, have you?
You know I'm an ardent member of the WCTU.
I'm all ready for him. I've got the coffee percolating and everything.
Expecting someone, Carol?
Baldy. He's coming for his final test.
What's he studying for?
Me? Only he doesn't know it yet.
Do you know what she's talking about?
I think she's entered her first stage of being boy conscious.
That's Baldy.
You mean to say she never knew they existed?
She knew they existed, only now they've justified themselves.
Gee, Mrs. Sutton, have you seen tonight's newspaper?
Why, no. You have a copy? May I see it, please?
It's right there on the front page.
Oh, it's true. Mrs. Radcliffe has won the appointment. Oh, the ignominy of it all.
I don't mean that, Mrs. Sutton. I mean the story about Henrietta. Only she's not Henrietta at all.
What do you mean?
It's right there. It's Henrietta, and she's famous.
Harriet Hall, popular novelist and author of Heritage of Hate, is acting as a secretary for a prominent club woman in this city for the sole purpose of gathering materials for her new book. Its central character we see to be is a woman who gives too much time to clubs and politics and too little time to her own daughters.
And that's Henrietta.
So it is.
Henrietta, why didn't you tell us?
Are you Harriet Hall?
Are you really writing a book about us?
That's my pen name. My real name is Henrietta Carver. I'm sorry you had to learn about it this way, Mrs. Sutton. I am writing a book about you and your girls.
Do you hear that, Mama? We're going to be in a book. So you mean to tell me that you became my secretary for the sole purpose of using me as a guinea pig?
That was my original intention. My original concept for the book was a satire on a club woman who subordinated her daughters in her own selfish desire to gain renown in the public eye.
Harriet Hall, I can't believe it.
Selfish, shallow, empty. Oh, this is more than a mortal can bear.
Let me finish.
I think you said enough.
Not quite. Come here, girls. I want you both to listen to this. When I first came here, it was my original intention to study you as characters for my book. But as the days went by, I began to realize I liked you more than an impartial author should. And that's when I changed the concept of my book.
You mean you're not going to write a book about us?
No, I'm still writing a book about you, but the concept has undergone some drastic changes. I think you'll be proud and a bit pleased too, Mrs. Sutton.
I suppose you're right. Perhaps I was a bit hasty.
My mother, you'll be famous when people know.
Why, yes, dear, I suppose you're right. I wonder what Annabelle will say to that.
When will the book be finished?
Well, it will take a couple months, but it'll go much faster now that I'm going to be my own boss again.
You mean you're going to leave us?
Well, I can't very well stay here now.
We're going to miss you, Henrietta.
Oh, I'm going to miss you girls, too.
I'll get that.
Henrietta? Can I get your signature?
Sure, Molly.
Write something nice, won't you?
Look what the tide brought in.
Hello, everybody. My gosh, Wilma, you've grown up. You're pretty.
Dizzy, what's happened to you?
No, not this tie. This one cost me $3.
The tie is perfect, Dizzy. Everything about you is perfect.
It is? I mean, it is. Ready to go?
Yes.
So long, everybody.
Have a lovely evening and a wonderful night.
We will. Don't eat too much, dear.
Gee, Wilma, you make me bumpy all over.
Baldy, come here.
What's up?
Hold out your hands, eyes closed, palms upward.
Now look, a pie.
Mm-hmm.
And you made it all yourself?
Yeah.
The pillow too?
No, just a pie.
When can I eat it? The pie, I mean.
Right now. I've got a place in the breakfast nook all set up.
Lead me to it. I have a feeling I'm going to love you for all this pie is worth.
These flowers came just for you, Mrs. Sutton. Mrs. Sutton? What's wrong with her?
She didn't hear you.
Flowers for you, Mrs. Sutton. What? Oh, flowers? For me?
For you.
I haven't gotten flowers in years. I wonder who could have... Judge Crandall! To a very fine woman whom I hope to get to know better, please dine with me tomorrow at 7. My car will call for you. Until then, think of me as your very good friend, Casper. Oh, Judge, they're beautiful! Flowers from the judge for me! Oh, Casper, you wicked, wicked, lovely man.
I'll see who that is on my way.
Hello, Henny. Is everything under control?
Don't get angry, says he. I can explain everything. We'll explain this, big boy, but quick.
Me like that. It wasn't my fault.
Fine agent you turned out to be. How could you allow such publicity to be released?
It was a publicity stunt on the part of your publishers. They didn't consult me.
But I didn't tell them. How did they find out?
Well, you see, I was talking to DJ the other day.
I'm beginning to see the light.
Oh, you know how he is, Henny. He's got this uncanny way of finding things out.
How could you? You idiot! Now I can't stay here anymore. And I really wanted to.
Good. Then we can be married tomorrow.
Why, I wouldn't marry you, Ray Taylor, if you...
If I promised you a church wedding, would you?
Oh, Ray, would you really?
Right down the center aisle of that little church in your own hometown.
Oh, Ray, you're a darling.
Where are the girls?
Wilma's out at the moment and Carol's a little preoccupied.
Well, our schedule says 5 minutes dancing in this house, 5 minutes of dancing is gonna be. Come on, Dave. See you and me again.
Everybody enjoyed the show. Now please make your way outside to meet the cast.